Hello guys, welcome to BGP class. Today we are going to discuss regarding the BGP neighbor, or you can say the peer formation. Okay, so let's move on. That's so about the BGP. So BGP abbreviation is the Border Gateway Protocol. So what it is used for? Mainly it is used for the inter AS communication. When we want to exchange the routes, they can be in millions between the different ASs. Okay, so let's come into the how the neighbor, or you can say the peer formation, takes place into the BGP, right? So BGP, for its transport mechanism of its message, uses the TCP at layer 4, right? So it uses the well-known port number 179. Okay, so when we configure the BGP between, or you can say specifically the EBGP, we define some commands, right? We all the things that we provide is the static. It is not like the IGP where you just enable the routing protocol onto the interfaces and they will automatically discover the neighbors. In here, everything is done statically, right? So you will tell its neighbor who's the neighbor is going to be, at what AS it is at, okay, to the both of the routers who are going to form the neighborship, right? And in the IGP, what happens? Simply you have to enable the command onto the interfaces and automatically the neighbor discovery takes place and they form the neighborship, right? So let's move on and see into the details what it look like. So here we have a whiteboard. So we have the two, for example, two routers, router 1 and router 2. Right. So its IP is 10.1.1.1/24 and its IP is 10.1.1.2/24. Okay, so, and this is an AS100, this is AS200. So we are going to start the BGP process for the AS100 onto the R1 and onto the R2 AS200. Right, as we have discussed, they uses the TCP at layer 4 for the transportation, for the transport mechanism. So first of all, the three-way handshake will occur, right? When you will tell this router that this is your neighbor and this is in this AS, okay? How you are going to tell it? You are going to start, first of all, you are going to start with the router BGP 100 command, means you have given its this router the AS of 100, okay? And you are going to tell him what your neighbor is, okay? So its neighbor is going to be 10.1.1.2, that is the IP of the R2. So 10.1.1.2, and you are also going to tell what the remote router's AS is. Okay, its AS you are going to tell him, remote AS is 200. Okay, as soon as you will do it, now what will happen? This router will start to send him the SYN message. Okay, and also as you have configured the BGP, so what does it mean? It means that as the BGP works on layer 4 and the port number 179, it will start to listen at port number 179, and also it's going to reply if the TCP SYN message will come for the destination of 179. So it is listening as well as it is sending also, right? So first of all, the SYN will happen. So into the SYN, you will see the source port as the random port. It can be any port, but it has to be a random. So let's take it as 10,000. Okay, and the destination port will be the well-known port for the BGP, that is 179, right? So the at the layer 4, the source port will be the random one, and the destination port will be 179 because it is heading onto the BGP. And but the source IP and the destination IP. So the destination IP will be the neighbor IP that you have configured, that is 10.1.1.2. And now the source IP. How the source IP will be chosen? Source IP will be chosen by 10.1.1.2. It will look into its routing table and do a recursive lookup, and it will find out the exit interface, right? In our example, this router will be having a connected route of 10.1.1.0/24. Okay, via interface, let's give it a name, that is serial 1/0, and this is also serial 1/0. So connected via serial 1/0. So when it will do a recursive lookup for its neighbor, that is 10.1.1.2, it will find out to which interface the messages are going to send to reach to the 10.1.1.2. So it will be the interface, serial interface 1/0. And serial interface 1/0 holds the IP of 10.1.1. So the source IP will be 10.1.1. Okay, accordingly, according to the chosen exit interface. And how the exit interface will be chosen? According to the recursive lookup into the routing table. Right? So this is the SYN. Now, this router, what it will do? For now, as we have not configured anything, we haven't configured a BGP process into it. So it is going to send the reset flag. Okay, it will keep on sending, resetting the connection it is sending you with a reset flag. So what we need to do here, we need to also start a BGP process here by giving it a command, router BGP 200. Okay, this is the AS number of this router, local router. Okay, then we need to also define here the neighbor. The neighbor is 10.1.1.1 and the AS of R1, that is 10.1.1.1, it is in 100. So the remote AS is going to be 100. Okay, as soon as we will give this command, now previously as there was no command, so it was resetting the connection, now it will start to reply. Now it will send the acknowledgement of the SYN and it will also send the SYN. That simply means the second step into the TCP three-way handshake, that is SYNAC. Okay, so it will send the SYNAC, okay, just these things will be reversed. Now here, the source port will be the 179, destination port will be the 10,000, source IP at the layer 3 will be 10.1.1.2 and the destination IP will be 10.1.1.1. So that will be into the SYNAC. And simple, this router is now going to send him a ACK. Okay, and the TCP three-way handshake will complete. Now after the three-way handshake will complete, now what they will do, they will exchange the capabilities. Okay, they will exchange the capability like route refresh capabilities. Okay, then after that they will send the BGP update messages and the keep live, and the adjacency will form, and at last you will see a message, or you can say the syslog will appear that will say the neighborship has been up, or you can say the adjacency has been up. Okay, so that is regarding to the BGP formation when we are doing the BGP neighborship onto the simple interfaces, right? So that is really easy. But what into the production network, what you will see, they never form the neighborship via the simple interfaces. What is preferred is you should form the neighborship with the loopback addresses. Okay, so first of all, we will discuss why it is necessary to form the neighborship with the loopback addresses. Okay, then we will go into the details, what are the details and what are the other things. But first, let's do the practical of the simple configuration. Let's go to the CLI. Okay, here is the router 1, we are going to start it. Here is the router 2, we are going to start it. So they have the serial 1/2 and serial 1/2 connected to each other. We are going to simply give them the IP and form the neighborship. Let's start the router 1. It will take a little bit time to boot up, and also the router 2. Okay, so let's, they will start for a moment. Let's go to our next slide and see what the next slide is all about. Okay, so as we have discussed, again the same thing. So the router should agree onto the their neighbor. Whatever the neighbor statement you are going to give. Okay, for example, onto the router, you have configured my neighbor is 10.1.1.2. Okay, so but it is getting the messages from some other IP. For example, it is getting from 20.1.1 or its other interface is chosen as the exit interface, right? So now the neighborship will not come up because that router is not agreeing. It is expecting the connection according to the configuration you have done, right? But it is not getting that, right? So in that case, it will send him the reset. Okay, it will simply refuse that I'm not going to form the neighborship with you. Okay, and what will happen when we will do the neighborship with the loopbacks, we are going to change the update source, you know, by default as the exit interface is chosen. So how we can give the source according to us, that is the update source command, we will also see when we form the neighborship with the loopbacks. So let's go and look into our lab. Okay, our router has been booted up. So simple, that is a fresh router. We are going to set no, that is a setup mode. You already know about it. So that is our router, router one. So we are going to give it a host name so that we can remember on which router we are working on, R1. Hostname R1 and give its interface serial 1/2, the IP of 10.1.1.1. And let's go to the router 2 also. Give it a, first of all, give it a hostname R2 and give the interface serial 1/2, 10.1.1.2. And now let's configure the, on the R2 we are going to configure the AS200 with the command router BGP 200. Okay, and give then the neighbor command. So the neighbor is going to be the R1 whose IP is 10.1.1 and the remote AS is going to be 100. So we are done. So let's also see the debugs. Okay, what the messages are popping up. Debug IP BGP. Right. And also on the debugs onto the R1. Okay, so you will see the, so actually that is not the part of this class, but you are going to see that routers are fluctuating onto the state, that is ideal and the active. Okay, so that will come, and you will also see that the reset flag is coming onto that router. Okay, so let's also configure for now and let's see the you can also view the TCP session that are presently onto your router with the TCP brief command. There is no presently no active TCP connection onto the R2. Okay, you can also debug the IP packet. Okay, so we have opened the debug of the IP packet and let's see, you can here see the output of the debug. Output of the debug as well as the port numbers, what it is hitting on with that debug. So as you can see, the source has been 10.1.1.2 and the destination has been 10.1.1.1. Okay, and you can also see the source port is the random port, that is 59334, and the destination port it is hitting on is the 179. Right, so that what the R2 is sending, but as on the R1 there is no BGP configuration has been done, so it is sending the reset flag. You can see the reset flag here, it is sending you the reset flag with the source port of 179, destination port the same port that you have generated it. Okay, and the source IP is 10.1.1.1 and destination is 10.1.1.2. okay, so that is how what we have discussed. Now let's move on to the R1 and complete the configuration. Router BGP 100. IP BGP. That's also on the debug, and we will see the completion of the neighborship. Neighbor is the 10.1.1.2, and the remote AS is going to be 200. Okay, so let's see onto the R1, R2, and let's also configure. Okay, so you can see that at last the message has pop up, the neighborship has been up, and here are the more messages. Okay, TCP 3-way handshake is has been established. You can also see with the TCP brief command. So in here you will see the established TCP connection at the port number 179, right? And you will also, and you can also view the present neighborship with the show IP BGP summary command. Okay, so let's look into the debugs and we will see. Here first let's see where the TCP three-way handshake is, and here you can also see at the last that TCP session has been established, right? So here is the TCP three-way handshake from here, that is the acknowledgement. We will go a little bit up. Move a little bit up, so there are too much debugs, we are not able to see. Okay, so it has been, the TCP three-way handshake has been established with the port number of 179 at 55472 as that destination port. Okay, so that is all about the BGP neighborship, right? And on the next class we are going to cover regarding the neighborship through the loopbacks, and we will also look into the update source loopback command, EBGP multi-hop, and TTL security, okay, and disable connected check. Thank you.